Let us see what is Ferranti effect. As in our previous videos, we have derived the equation of voltage and current on a long transmission line, wherein we could write voltage at any point of the line was given by VR plus IR ZC by 2 e raised to power gamma x plus VR minus IR ZC by 2 e raised to power minus gamma x, where ZC is characteristic impedance, gamma is the propagation constant. Both can be complex quantities. Similarly, current was given by VR by ZC plus IR by 2 e raised to power gamma x minus VR by ZC minus IR by 2 or e raised to power minus gamma x. Okay, where x was measured from receiving end to sending end, that is at the receiving end x is equal to 0 and at the sending end x is equal to L. Now let us see what happens to the voltage at various points of the line. V at 0, that is at the receiving end, is equal to VR by 2 plus IR ZC plus VR minus IR ZC by 2. Okay. Now we are trying to study the Ferranti effect. Now what is Ferranti effect? In Ferranti effect, on a long transmission line, when the load is very low, that is the current on the line is very small or the line is open ended, then the voltage at the receiving end is higher than that at the sending end. That is, if I have, let us say, at the sending end voltage magnitude equal to Vs, then I will find that the magnitude of the voltage at the receiving end, which is Vr, will be greater than the sending end, which usually, you know, does not coincide with the common sense which our brain will think. But this phenomena occurs due to the capacitance of the line. So we will see mathematically how we can explain Ferranti effect. Okay, now when IR is very small or approximately equal to 0, that is the line is open ended, then I can write V at R is equal to VR by 2 plus VR by 2 from this equation. Let us write it as equation B and this as equation A. Now what I can see about the voltage at the sending end, voltage at sending end will be equal to, let us say, capital L is the length of the line. It will be equal to V sending end is equal to VR by 2 e raised to power gamma L plus VR by 2 e raised to power minus gamma L. Okay. Now we already know that gamma is a, you know, complex quantity which can be written as gamma is equal to alpha plus j beta, where this will imply the phase and this will imply the decay or the rise. Okay, so putting this value of gamma here, what I will get? I will get Vs equal to Vr by 2 e raised to power alpha L e raised to power j beta L plus VR by 2 e raised to power minus gamma L e raised to power minus j beta L. Okay. So, from this equation C, I can get this value if I put the value of gamma in this equation. Now, in the next slide, we will see how to use these two equations. Equation, let us say equation 1 and this is equation 2 to make some kind of phasor to ascertain the value of the voltage magnitude at various points of the line. We will see in the next slide. In the previous slide, we have derived two equations of the voltage wave. Voltage at the receiving end was just composed of two parts, VR by 2 plus VR by 2. That was equation number 1. And voltage at the sending end was equal to VR by 2 e raised to power alpha L e raised to power j beta L plus VR by 2 e raised to power minus alpha L e raised to power minus j beta L. This was equation number 2. So, here we have shown that voltage consists of two parts. First one is the forward wave and that one is the reflected wave or the backward wave. Okay. Now, we will try to make the phasor diagram. You see that this part, in this equation 1, these are only magnitudes, but here in the sending end voltage equation, this part represents the magnitude. Similarly, this also represents the magnitude, and the remaining part represents the phase. So, again, this voltage wave consists of two parts, in which one is magnitude of the forward wave, phase of the forward wave, magnitude of the backward wave and the phase of the backward wave. Now, let's try to draw the phasor equation, phasor diagram. Let us say that this is VR by 2. Similarly, the same length, again, let us say this part is again VR by 2. So, in total, what I will get? I will get this as VR, the total voltage value at the receiving end. Now, let us try to draw these two parts. Here, I can see that VR by 2 has its magnitude increased exponentially by e raised to power alpha L, and here the magnitude is reduced by e raised to power minus alpha L. And the phase, first phase is in the forward direction and the other phase in the reverse direction, and the magnitudes are equal. So, let us try to draw the first part. Let us say this value is beta L, the phase angle, advanced in phase. So, this is VR by 2 and let us say it increases exponentially to, this whole value represents VR by 2 e raised to power alpha L. Similarly, I will make another phasor with angle minus beta L or the angle in the reverse direction. With magnitude just VR by 2 e raised to power minus alpha L. Now, I will add these two phasors, first phasor and the second phasor, to get the resultant value. So, I will make a phasor parallel to this. And I will add these two, giving me the resultant phasor as, let me choose a different color. this, and this represents the total sending end voltage. Now you can see that the length of this phasor is smaller than this total phasor. So clearly the magnitude at the sending end voltage is smaller than the magnitude at the receiving end. Okay, so this shows how Ferranti effect can be explained using just the voltage equation which we have derived for the long line. Whenever the long line is lightly loaded or not, there is no load, then the receiving end voltage magnitude is higher than the sending end voltage magnitude.